गुड मॉर्निंग, ओम शांति। टुडे इज 21st May 2024। बाबा साकार वर्जन। सेंस ऑफ टुडेज मोरली। बाबा से स्वीट चिल्ड्रन, शिव बाबा इज अ वंडरफुल फादर, टीचर एंड सतगुरु। ही डजंट हैव अ फादर ऑफ हिज ओन। ही नेवर लर्न्स एनीथिंग विथ एनीवन। ही डजंट नीड टू हैव अ गुरु। You should remember him with such wonder. So today's main point, how to remember Baba with such wonder. What is the wonder? That Baba is our father, teacher and Satguru. Mainly with the three role he is acting in this confluence age. He is such a father, teacher and Satguru whose he is not having his own father, teacher or Satguru. He don't need to have teachings from anybody or to have Mukti and Jivan Mukti from anybody. So such a wonderful Baba is coming and we have to remember him. Question from today's Murli: what newness should there be in your remembrance so that you souls can easily become pure? Now we have to remember Baba, but Baba says, what is the newness here that is different than the devotion? So Baba replies, when you sit in remembrance, continue to draw a current from the Father. You look at the Father and the Father looks at you. It is such remembrance that purifies souls. This remember is very easy. But some children repeatedly forget that they are souls and not bodies. Only soul-conscious children can stay in remembrance. So first main thing, first lesson, consider yourself to be a soul. Stabilize yourself in your own energy that is called soul-conscious. Then remember the Father. Baba has given full description, full introduction of his own, that he is point of light. He is a sparkling star. So Baba has given also vision to us. So we have to connect our intellect and mind with the supreme point, that is point of light, that is sparkling star in the in our own that home. So that is the correct way of remembrance. Then only soul can catch the power of Baba and soul can purify whatever the impurities are there in the soul. Since last 63 birth, that we can remove, it can be burnt and soul can be pure. Om Shanti. So you sweetest children have the faith that our Father is the unlimited Father and that he doesn't have a father of his own. He is unlimited Father. How? Because he is Father of all souls of all religions in the world. There isn't any human beings in the world who doesn't have a father. Each and every point has to be understood very clearly, and the one who is giving you this knowledge is the one who has never studied. So today, how many times Baba told that he is such a father whom he is not having his own father. He is not studying from anybody and teaching us. So he don't have any Satguru. These points have so many times Baba has pointed out today. Baba says, otherwise human beings definitely study one thing or another. Sri Krishna too studies, because Sri Krishna is also human being. The father asks, what would I study? I have come to teach you. He is ocean of knowledge, so he need not study that he has to teach us. I have not studied with anyone. I haven't taken teachings from anyone. I haven't adopted any gurus. According to the drama plan, the praise of the father would definitely be the highest of all. So Baba, see Baba, what a great Baba entity is there. Baba says, it is as per the drama, his praise is there in the devotion, that he is highest on high. He is supreme authority. He is accepted by all the souls of the all religions, he is the ocean of everything. So that is his praise. It is remembered that God is the highest on high. Who would be higher than him? Nobody in the world is higher than him. No father, teacher or guru. The unlimited father says, no father, teacher or guru. He himself is the father, teacher and guru. You can understand this very well. There cannot be such a human being. You have to remember such a father, teacher and Sadguru with such wonder. People say, oh God, the father, he is also the knowledgeful teacher and the supreme guru. He is the only one. There isn't any another being like him. So he is also being, supreme being. He has to teach you through a human body. He definitely needs a mouth in order to teach you. If he wants to give some knowledge to human beings, so naturally he has to use the mouth of human being. If you children repeatedly remember this, your boards can go across. Only by having remembrance will your sins be absolved. By knowing him as the supreme teacher, all of this knowledge will enter in your intellects. He is also the Satguru who is teaching us yoga. You have to have yoga with the one alone. So how he liberates us, how he gives us salvation, Baba says, we have to connect our intellect yoga with him. All souls have the one father. He says to all souls, constantly remember me alone. It is the soul that does everything. It is the soul that controls the motor, the body. So the body is just like a motor and soul is just like a driver. So the soul controls this body. You can call it a chariot or anything else. The soul is the main one that controls everything. So Baba says main is soul. Soul is governing the body. Soul is governing, we can say, chariot, we can say motor. So the father of all souls is the one. You even say that all of you are brothers. We are all brothers, children of one father, supreme power. Then when the father enters the body of Prajapita Brahma, we have to become brothers and sisters. So how we are brothers and sisters? Baba says, when I enter a body and give him the name as Brahma, and he is a Prajapita Brahma, means spiritual father of all we Brahmins, then Baba says, with that relation, you all Brahmins are brothers and sisters. The mouth-born creation of Prajapita Brahma would be brothers and sisters. A brother cannot marry his sister. Now we are mouth-born creation of Brahma. So Brahma is our father. So Baba says the brother and sisters, they cannot marry. It's a scientific reason, genetic reason. That issues, they will have some problem that science has approved. So they cannot marry. And in India, they will so see the Gotra also. So they will not marry. So all of you are Prajapita Brahma, Kumars and Kumaris. By considering yourselves to be brothers and sisters, you become the lovely children of God's community. Very important sentence. Baba says, you would say that you are the direct community of God. We are direct creation, direct community of God. God, Baba, is teaching us everything. He hasn't learned anything from anyone. He is constantly perfect. His degrees never decrease, whereas the decrease of everyone else do. So Baba's power of purity never decrease. His power is constant. He is constantly perfect. So Baba says he is sun, just like physical sun, the sun's degree never decrease, thus he is also Gyan Surya, and we all are stars. So our comparison is supreme star, that is a moon. So So Baba says, but Baba is son, so his degrees are permanent. We praise Shiv Baba a lot. It is very easy to say Shiv Baba. It is only the father who is the purifier. It doesn't seem right simply to say. It doesn't seem right simply to say God. But simply to say God is not right. How the father comes and makes all impure ones pure now touches your hearts. There is your physical father and also your paralokic father. Everyone remembers the paralokic father. They remember him because they are impure. You know, why remember? Because all are impure. Once you have become pure, there is no need to call out to the purifier. The deities, they don't call out because they are pure. So look what the drama is like. You remember the purifier father because you want to become the master of the pure world. In the scripture, they have shown a battle between the deities and the devilies, but it is not like that. Baba says the deities cannot be in the time of this Iron Age where devils are there, and devils cannot enter the kingdom of deities, which is established by God himself for his children. So Baba says, but our sanskars of we are now Brahmins, we are making efforts to become deities. So we are possessing the sanskar of deities, but sometimes the sanskar of devils will also emerge. So there is tug of war between that sanskars, both sanskar, that is goodness and badness. But physically, Baba says, there is no such battle between deities and devils. You now understand that we are neither deities nor devils. We are becoming deities, and now also we are not devils. We are now in between the two. You all continue to grind this into yourselves, just like sandwich. We are going to this side, sometimes coming there, back this side. So sometimes we are just being grind. So this is a very enjoyable play. Baba ke, this is nothing but a play. And the play, that play also we are enjoying, just like this is also a play we have to enjoy. In a play, you just watch the entertainment. All of those are limited drama, whereas this is drama unlimited. No one else knows it. Even deities cannot know it. So we are so lucky. We Brahmins are so lucky. We know the drama through our father. You have now moved away from the Iron Age. Those who know this can also explain it to others. Once you have seen a... Sorry. Once you have seen a particular drama, the whole of the drama stays in your intellect. That physical drama, if we have seen, the whole story will narrate to our friends and family members. Baba has explained to you that this is the human world tree, and that its seed is up above. Now see, Baba has given full knowledge of this world drama. So how we have to narrate to others, that Baba is telling today. Now Baba says, Baba is this is the human world tree, and Baba is the seed of this tree. They speak of the variety form images. The father sits here and explains to you children. People don't know this. Would Shiv Baba have learnt a language from anyone? Since he doesn't have a teacher, what language would he have learnt? If he has to learn the language, then he must have some teacher. So he would definitely use the language of chariot. He has entered. But because there is no guru, so Baba will naturally use the language of the chariot. He doesn't have a language of his own. Baba don't have any own language. He doesn't study of or learn anything. He doesn't have a teacher of his own. Sri Krishna learns everything. Baba says Sri Krishna also have teacher. He has joined the Sandipani Rishi Ashram, and he was his teacher. So he has a mother also, father and teacher. Sri Krishna has a mother, father and teacher. He doesn't need a guru because he has already received salvation. Sri Krishna doesn't need guru because already he is in salvation. Only you know this. You Brahmins are the highest of all. You have to keep this in your awareness. It is the Father who is teaching you. We are now Brahmins. It is very clear. Brahmins, then deities, then warriors, then Vaishya, Sudra, and so on. So you say of the God that he knows everything, but you don't know what it is that he knows. What God knows, that nobody knows. He is knowledgeful. He has the knowledge of the beginning, middle, and the end of the world drama. Because he is the creator and director of this world drama. So he is having full knowledge about the world drama, the beginning, middle, and end of the drama. A seed has the knowledge of the whole tree. And likewise, Baba is a seed of this human world tree. He is a living seed. So he is having full knowledge about this tree. Those are non-living seeds, whereas you are living. Baba says that physical trees, their seeds, it is a non-living. So if that seed don't know anything about the tree. But we all are living, so we know it. Living in the sense we have mind, that is thought power, we have intellect to examine and to make decision. That is the element of livingness. So you explain the knowledge of your tree. The Father says, I am the seed of this variety human world. All are human beings, but there is variety. Different features, different color, different height, different language, different this lifestyle. The features of the body of not a single soul can be the same as those of another. No two actors can be the same. This is an unlimited drama. We don't refer to human beings as actors, but to souls as actors. Baba says, people of the world, they consider the actors, that human beings with the concept of body, and we consider the souls as an actor. So soul is playing the part in this world drama. Soul is changing the costume. Sometimes of male.
Om Shanti, sister.
Yes.
So, it is not necessary to explain all the sentences. Main thing you can, but is time is going but, on. That's the one.
Yes, thank you. But those new ones who will listen this recording, they should also know. That's why. Okay, thank you. So those people consider human beings to be actors. It is in your intellects that you souls are actors. Those people dance just as people make monkeys dance. So too, Baba says, it is the soul that makes the body dance. He makes it play this part. These things are very easy to understand. The unlimited Father definitely comes. It isn't that he doesn't come. There is also the birth of Shiva. The Father comes when the world has to change. So we are celebrating Shivratri. That is the proof of his coming. On the path of the devotion, they continue to remember Sri Krishna. But how could Sri Krishna comes? It is not possible to see the form of Sri Krishna with your physical eyes in the Iron Age or the Confluence Age. Because in the devotion, it is the belief that Sri Krishna told the knowledge of Gita. That point Baba is making clear with this point, that this is the Confluence Age. In this Confluence Age or Iron Age, Sri Krishna cannot come with, and we cannot see him with this physical eyes, the same real images. So Baba says, how can he be called God? And God has given this knowledge. Sri Krishna cannot come here now. So Baba says, how he can be called God? So he is the number one prince of the golden age. He has a father and a teacher, but doesn't need a guru because he is in salvation. Heaven is called salvation. The account is clear. You children understand that human beings take 84 births. You saw the account of how many births they take. The deity clan definitely comes first. Their births are the first births. When the first one takes birth, all of the others come after them. When number one deity is ascending in this world drama, After him, all the souls of his clan, they will just come. So you know these things. Some of you also understand these things very well. Just as it is easy in those studies, so this too is very easy. There is just one incognito difficulty. What is the difficulty, incognito? Maya creates obstacles in your having remembrance of the father because Maya Rama is jealous. When you remember Ram, Ravan is jealous and thinks, why is my slave remembering Ram? Actually, this slave word is also not proper. The followers, the follower word is proper. This is also mixed in the drama beforehand. It is not anything new. You would play the same part that you played in the previous cycle. You are now making efforts. You are making the same effort that you made in the previous cycle. This cycle continues to turn. It never ends. Time continues to tick away. The father explains that this drama is of 5,000 years. They have written such different things in the scriptures. The father never asks you to stop doing devotion because if you then become unable to continue here and had also let go of it, you would be neither here nor there. So Baba will not say, we are also not saying anybody to stop devotion. So that part we don't know. So Baba says, that's why initially we should not say, you would then be of no use. This is why you see that some human beings are such that they don't perform any devotion. They simply continue to move along in life just like that. Some say that God himself adopts many forms. But this is an eternally predestined, unlimited drama which continues to repeat. This is why it is called an eternal, imperishable world drama. Only you children can understand it. And it is very easy for you Kumaris. Baba says for Kumaris it is very easy. Because Baba says that energy is preserved. The mothers have to climb down the ladder that they climbed up. The ladder of Baba says impurity, mothers have climbed up. So naturally they have climbed down. So Kumaris don't have any other bondages. They don't have any other thoughts. They can just belong to the father. You have to forget your worldly relationship and forge a parlokic relationship. In the irony is there is degradation. According to the drama, you have to come down. This is noted in the drama, so you have to come down. The people of Bharat say that all of this belongs to God. He is the master. Who are you? Baba is asking. I am a soul, but all of these belong to God. All of these, including this body, etc., has been given by the Supreme Soul. In the devotion, we were singing that everybody belongs to you. This body, this mind, this wealth, everything. So Baba says, when everything belongs to God, then why you are worried? They say this and that is fine. They say that everything has been given by God. Achha, so you should not then have any dishonesty in looking after that which has been given to you. However, they don't understand this. They simply follow the directions of Ravan. The father explains, you are trusty, but because this is the community of Ravan, you deceive yourself in being trusty. You say one thing and you do something else. That is called being, Baba says, a deceive, this trusteeship. The father gave you something and then took it away. And so why should you feel sorrow about that? If the child is will leave the body, then we were telling that God has taken it. Baba says when God has given, then we should not have sorrow about it. The father explains all of these things to his children in order to finish their attachment. So this is a trick of Baba just to make us free from the attachment. The father has now come. You called out, Baba, take us back with you. We are very unhappy in the kingdom of Ravan. Come and make us pure. This is because you understand that you cannot go back without becoming pure. Take us back with you. Where? Take us home. Everyone says that they want to go home. The devotees of Sri Krishna want to go to paradise, the land of Krishna. They simply continue to remember the golden age. It is something so lovely. When a person dies, he doesn't go to heaven. Heaven is in the golden age and hell is in the iron age. Hey, even though people say if somebody leave the body, they will say he has gone to abroad, heaven. So surely rebirth would also take place in hell. This is not the golden age. That is a wonder of the world. A golden age is the wonder of the world. They say this, they understand it. And yet when someone dies, their relatives don't understand anything. Only the father who has this knowledge of the cycle of 84 births can give it to you. You used to consider yourselves to be bodies, but that was wrong. The father now says, may you be soul conscious. Sri Krishna cannot say, may you be soul conscious, because he is having his own body. He has a body of his own. Shiv Baba doesn't have a body of his own. This is his chariot in which he is present. This is that one's chariot and also this one's chariot. Means chariot of Shiv Baba and also of Brahma Baba. So there is this one's own soul too. The father has taken this body on loan. The father says, I take the support of this one. I do not have a body of my own. So how would I teach you? The father sits here every day and pulls you to make you consider yourselves to be souls and look at the father. Even this body should be forgotten. I look at you and you look at me. That's why in yoga, just we are concentrating our mind and intellect with that point of light. So we can have the energy of Baba. It will flow in our soul. The more you look at the father, the purifier you will continue to become. There is no other way to become pure. If there is another way, means then so that that way through which a soul can become pure. A soul will not become pure with the water of Ganges. First of all, you have to give someone the father's introduction. No other father is like that one. Feel their pulse and see if they have understood sufficiently that they become amazed. They should understand that that one truly is the Supreme Soul. The father is now giving you children his own introduction as to who he is. Children also know that history repeats. Only those who belong to this clan will come. All of others will go into their own religions. Those who have been converted into other religions will emerge and come back to their own section. This is why the incorporeal tree has been sown. Baba has sown this incorporeal tree in Brahmand, in Paramdham. So Baba says those souls who are originally from this religion, deity religion, and has converted into other religions since the last some births, they will also come and they will just go and sit in their own sections. This is why the incorporeal tree has been sown. Only you children understand these things. Others hardly understand. Out of 7 of 8, there would be 1 or 2 who emerge, who think that this knowledge is very good. So Baba is telling the ratio. Those who belong here will have fewer storms. They would want to come here again to listen to this knowledge. But because that sanskar will just pull them to come here again and again. Some come here, but they then become colored by other company and they don't come back a second time. Baba says, wherever they see a group of going, they would join it. It takes a lot of effort. So much effort has to be made. You repeatedly say that you forget I am a soul and not this body. You repeatedly forget this. The father knows that you children have become ugly by sitting on the pyre of lust. You have been buried in the graveyard because we are in body consciousness. So it is just like a graveyard. This is how you have become ugly, because the energy of the body will reflect on the soul. So the father says to you, all of my children have been burned. This is an unlimited matter. In the devotion, the story of Sagar Raja is there. We all are children of that sun. So the sun means see Baba. So there are so many millions of souls who are going to reside in my home. That is, they are going to reside in Brahmalok. Baba says, my home, Brahmalok. That is a tree of all souls. So all souls will reside there. The father is in the unlimited. You will also go into the unlimited. Brahman, it is an unlimited space. Father is there. We will also go there in that unlimited. You know that Baba will carry out establishment and then depart, and you will then rule the kingdom. All the other souls will go back to the land of peace. So Baba will go. Along with Baba, all souls will go, and then we will come again in the part. Achha, to the sweetest, beloved, long lost, and now found children, love, remembrance, and good morning from the mother, the father, Bap, Dada. The spiritual father says namaste to the spiritual children, and we spiritual children with love say namaste to our मदर फादर बाप दादा मीठे मीठे सिकिल दे बच्चों प्रति मात पिता बाप दादा का याद प्यार और गुड मॉर्निंग रूहानी बाप की रूहानी बच्चों को नमस्ते हम रूहानी बच्चों की रूहानी मात पिता बाप दादा को याद प्यार गुड मॉर्निंग और नमस्ते शुक्रिया बाबा थैंक यू वेरी मच सो एसेंस फॉर धारणा फ्रॉम टुडेज मुरली पॉइंट नंबर वन इवन इफ रावण बिकम्स जेलस ऑफ यू एक्टर्स If he creates obstacles or brings storms to you, do not see those, but remain engrossed in your efforts because each actor has his own individual part to play in this drama. This eternal drama is predestined. And Baba says himself, if somebody is creating obstacles, this is only due to Maya Ravan only, but we know the We have the knowledge of drama, that everybody is playing their part accurately. So we should not come in effect of that obstacles. Second point, do not become dishonest by following the directions of Ravan while looking after the valuables entrusted to you. So remove your attachment from everyone and live as complete trustee. Now, blessing for today, may you have a constantly stable mood and give all souls a drop of happiness, peace, and love as a great donor. So we have to become great donor, but how we can become great donor? Our mood should be constantly of happiness. We should not be affected by any situation, by any person. So Baba is just explaining in detail about this blessing, let the mood of you children remain constantly stable and happy. Let it not be that you sometimes have an off mood or that your mood is sometimes very happy. The mood of those who are constantly great donors never change. To become a deity means to be a bestower. No matter what anyone gives you, You great donor children have to give everyone a drop of happiness, a drop of peace, and a drop of love. So if somebody is giving us unhappiness, makes us peaceless, Baba says they may hurt us, but we should not come in that effect. So together with serving with your bodies, also stay busy in serving with your mind, and you will accumulate double the charity. And we will accumulate the double charity with double services, with service with mind and body, and physical service and subtle service. So now slogan for today, your specialities are an offering from God. Do not use them just for yourself, but share them and thereby multiply them. So Baba says, don't be selfish. Use for self and everybody, and then only it will be multiplied. So we will give thanks, Baba, for a minute and finish the Murli.